Here in Gilmanton, they have no heat in the town hall, and trying to work in winter coats and scarves wasn't proving very practical, so they had to close it. It's one of just a number of problems the cold is causing across New Hampshire.
The temperature was only half the story, as the Arctic cold was accompanied by whipping winds, making it feel like double digits below zero. Despite that, work had to go on, clearing snow from downtown Manchester. In Concord, the same thing, as far as keeping warm.
I'm in and out of the truck really quick, no more than 5 minutes. Just keep moving, basically.
But in downtown Concord, it seemed very few things were moving, aside from the occasional bicyclist. The streets practically deserted by the cold.
I think I'm ready for summer, just like the rest of us. What's it, -4, I think it says, right there?
But others say it's New England. Deal with it.
I'm wearing my warmest coat. I'm trying to stay outdoors as little as possible, and I'm loving the snow and the sunshine.
And as Stephen Lorenz laced up his skates, he also didn't mind the cold.
This is pretty cold, but it's still good weather. It's great skating weather.
But it was rough weather to fight a fire, as firefighters in Canterbury dealt with temperatures that reached 14 degrees below zero. Fortunately, no one was injured, but the cold did cause some problems.
Our source engine froze up. We couldn't use the source, but you know, for water supply. But we actually had enough here on scene, so we just called in more trucks.
At the Gilmanton Town Hall, the thermometer also told the story as the town clerk tried to work bundled up for the cold.
We've told all the employees to stay home. Basically, we've announced it on the radio stations that we're closed due to no heat.
The repairman is now here and thinks he should be able to get the heat going, but the town administrator is worried that because it has been so cold, they might now be dealing with frozen pipes. Reporting live in Gilmanton, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.